Hi, if you have been diagnosed with epilepsy and been taking anti-seizure medications, then it is normal to ask yourself this question: how long I need to take those seizure medications, and will I be taking those anti-seizure medications for life or not? To answer this question, we have to first understand the nature of epilepsy. Epilepsy is a chronic condition, which means that there is no cure that completely takes off epilepsy. However, we have so many different and successful anti-seizure medications and treatment for epilepsy, and hence the name, they are called anti-seizure medications. They control the seizures, but they do not control the epilepsy process itself, so it is not a correct name to be called anti-epileptic drugs. This is like pressing a spring with your finger. As long as your finger is on the spring, it will stay cold and it stay calm, and even with a long time, if you take your finger off the spring, it will come back to springing, if you would say. And it is expected that seizures might come back after stopping the anti-seizure medications, and in some cases, they will completely stop, like you are putting your finger on the spring for a very long time to be able to completely stick it together and will not spring back. So this comes down to the cause of epilepsy and the initial response to treatment. The best case scenario here is if the epilepsy and seizure starts in children in between the ages of 4 to 6 years old, and the diagnosis and the cause of epilepsy is there is a syndrome and it is self-limiting, means that it will go away as the brain matures and adopts more of a adult side and adult brain. This is the best case scenario. We give anti-seizure medications, the seizures will completely stop for 2 years or longer, then we reevaluate, we do the EEG, we do all the testing, and if everything comes back normal, we can withdraw the medications and the chances of being cured is very high and likely that seizures will not come back. But unfortunately, this scenario is not very common in epilepsy treatment. In most of the epilepsy cases, when the cause is maybe genetic cause, means the build of the brain and the building blocks of the brain are irritable and causes seizures to happen, or there is a scar in the brain, like there is a stroke, brain tumor, or traumatic brain injury that led to epilepsy and the scar is permanent in the brain, or there is abnormal cell forming in the brain. All of those are kind of scars or changes that are permanent in the build of the brain, and the seizure medications will control those seizures and those situations, but will not completely abolish that scar or cure the cause of epilepsy, and it will stay in your brain for life. Because of that, you would need to take a medication for the long term and probably for life. This is considering that the seizures did get better and stopped with anti-seizure medication. And with that, there is a chance that we can stop the anti-seizure medications, but we have to do first some testing and evaluation, and I put all the details of how we can stop the anti-seizure medication successfully and what are the factors determining that in one video for adult and one video for children that I will link it down to in the description below for your reference. But what happens when the seizures do not get better and even continue to happen with the anti-seizure medications? After 1, 2, or 3 anti-seizure medications, the seizures continue to happen. In this case, the seizures are more stubborn, you would say, or difficult to control, and they are called drug-resistant epilepsy, and this is a special type of epilepsy that happens in about 25% of the time, so it is not rare. It happens a lot, about a quarter of the time, that we could not control the seizures with medications alone. And this situation, you will need to take medications for life because the seizures are not controlled with medications alone. And luckily, we have multiple new treatments now for the drug-resistant epilepsy and those stubborn types of seizures with surgical treatment and other implanted devices that we can do to cure epilepsy and help the seizures to stop, even if they are stubborn and difficult to control. And to do that, I put this video that has all the treatments for the drug-resistant epilepsy and what we can do in those difficult cases to control. And stay healthy, and see you in the next one. Salam.